So there is oxymercuration of alkynes, okay? And there's hydroboration of alkynes. So when we do an oxymercuration of an alkyne, what we're really doing is we're doing it a Markovnikov addition of alcohol. Okay? Remember that oxymercuration is the most popular way, one of the most popular ways to add a Markovnikov alcohol to a double bond. Well, the same thing applies for a triple bond as well. What that means is that if I have two sites, I have, let's say, the blue site and the red site, and I'm trying to figure out where the alcohol is going to go, it's going to go in the more substituted position. So I would expect that after an oxymercuration, I'm going to get an alcohol right here, okay, in the more substituted position. Now, notice that I put the oxymerc reagents down here, but I also included HA over H2O. Do you guys remember what that was? That's hydration. Okay, this would be an acid-catalyzed hydration. And just so you know, both of these create Markovnikov additions, right? Both of them favor the Markovnikov alcohol. So actually, I can use both of them. Even though oxymerc is maybe more commonly used, hydration is still a great choice. Okay? So both of these reagents really lead to the same intermediate structure, which is going to be this enol. All right? Are you getting that so far? The reason I'm calling it an enol is because now I have a Markovnikov alcohol on a double bond. But we know that it's not going to stay like that because enols are not stable. They like to tautomerize. So after the tautomerization process, what's the product going to look like? Well, the product is going to be the same ring, okay? But now, instead of having a single bond to O, I'm going to get a double bond to O. Instead of having a double bond to the carbon, I'm now going to have a single bond to the carbon. So it turns out that the product of oxymercuration or even hydration is going to be ketones. Okay? So anytime that I'm hydrating, Markovnikov hydrating a triple bond, I'm going to get a ketone as the product. Okay? Now, what part of this mechanism should you be able to draw? The first part. The second part, you are fine just to say tautomerization, just label it, and then draw the product. Okay? Like I said, I'm not going to teach you that full mechanism until we get to Orgo 2. All right? But for right now, you know at least the general idea of what's going on.